it's just amazing that he, before I came to this world, it was already in his head that he was going to have a girl like me. But he has made my own dreams come through by being the dad that he is. Somebody who I can confide in, somebody who gives me the best advice. And he looks good. He's a fine man, and that's why I look good too.
those are big old days. Let me run to hear him, but we need to work out. We're black men, so let me say, all young men put together. But he had a focus, always had a focus about to go for masters. So when he was going for masters, he laughed at him and said, I can't even live all this good life. You are going for masters. But hard working for him, and the time he went for masters, came back to share after the masters.
My dad always told me, you gotta study hard. Study hard to, is until blood drips on your books. Study hard until you start bleeding. And man, he would wake us up, he would wake me up in the middle of the morning, and at 5 o'clock in the morning, to go study. Man, those are some hard days, man. I fought through it, but if it wasn't for those days of studying hard, I don't think I would be where I am today.
As a father, I never chanted at any of them or screamed like I would do as a mother. For that, the children loved him more than I. That mom is too strict. Ah! Mommy would shout at you, mommy would do this, mommy would do this. They love their dad for that because he doesn't shout at them. Yet he has a way of sending down his messages to them. And I remember when they started university, you tell them, Joseph, you have not read until the blood starts dropping from your eyes into your nose. What? I said, look at this. When you read, the blood will drop from your eyes into your notebook. What is that for? It's for fun, it's just to send a message that you have to read as. Then I said, what's that? Oh, it's caring, it's loving, it's a keeper.
Mr. Mate is a remarkable person. You know, he's somebody that epitomizes hard work, integrity, and reflects in his family, everything. He's somebody with so much love and compassion for the family. You know, he's somebody that when you are in need, you go to him, he's ready to help. You can go beyond and above to help. Somebody with a big heart. In terms of professionalism, he's among the best that you could say in his job. You know, growing up, I remember when I was in university, some virtue that he taught me was hard work and integrity. And I can say today, those really reflect. And it pays. I want to say a big thank you, Mr. Martin.
Another memory I have of him was a few years ago. I don't let family see my Facebook, but this guy, I saw a picture that someone added me from Nigeria. There's a guy, there's a photo of him with my sister, so I thought that was my sister's boyfriend, so I thought I wanted to check him out to find out more about him, so I had accepted the caress. But it turned out it was some spy from my dad, so he could look on my Facebook. And I got a phone call the next day from Dad, and it was like, Marcus is your father. I have seen your Facebook, and I'm not happy. All it seems that you consider this party, and nothing else. And I was like, I sat there, I didn't know what to say. And he says, I see you with many photos of many with many women. And I asked myself, does my son intend on marrying all these women? and I just didn't know what to say. I was like, oh, okay.
One or two, at least one clearly stands out. The difference in our ages It's a mere 3 weeks, 21 days, calendar days. And when I go places with Martin, he has this air of superiority around him. He behaves as if he's like a decade older than me. And that's not true. In fact, there was one particular day he told me, he said, Adol, if we're in a village meeting, while I'm sitting with the elders, you'll be under the mango tree. In fact, that was amazingly funny, but that's a matter for me. That is one very fun memory of our relationship.
You should grant him long life, good health, to continue to make the positive impact that he's making to the lives of a lot of people, and that may he live long to enjoy the fruit of his labor.
There's so many words, man. Dad, I mean, you're a great man. I pray you live for a very long time, 40 more years, even more. You gotta see your grandkids for sure. There's one thing that you've always told me, never let success get into your head and never let failure wear you down. I always remember those words, every step. You gotta tell other people too, again, Dad, this is your day. Have fun, you're 60. I wish you the best. I love you so much. I mean, let's turn up. Enjoy.
I want to wish him all the best. Many more years. I definitely want my kids to be impacted as well, because yeah, he means a lot to me, and I want him around forever. So I wish him all the best and many, many, many.
60 is not a joke. I will tell you that we will be there. And you have to be more experienced what it is to be 60 years. So I wish you a very happy birthday. And welcome to the club. I wish you a happy 60th birthday. Happy 70th birthday. Our parents will come and go to see there. That's my wish for you.
Listen, man, he's just been a great guidance to me, especially in my later life. Great guidance, very generous, very supportive of me, giving me the right sort of guidance during my university time at university as well. If I could offer him one wish, one birthday wish would be for long life, long healthy life, because I don't intend to have any grandchildren, have any children yet, so it's going to be a long time before he'd be a granddad for me, so he's going to need to live long, you know what I mean? But besides that, yeah, but like I said again, absolutely so lucky to have him as my father. And happy birthday. Happy birthday, Dad.
Matty, as you turn 60 today, honestly, the only thing I can wish is God's perpetual guidance. The same God that has seen you through 60 years, I'm sure will see you through another 60. God willing, we'll all be there to celebrate with you. I'm sure God will grant our wish. But not only that, I just pray that your family situation continues to improve. Live bound. In other words, all the good things I wish myself, I wish for you and
young. We wish you many more years, many fruitful years, and loving years. As we celebrate this, I believe what you've achieved now is just the footstool. There are more to come. Happy birthday, Mr. Martin. I wish you a happy birthday.
Last two, like I used to call me. Today, being your birthday, I want to tell you, you are one out of a million husbands in this world. You are the best man. I'm happy that I got married to you. I don't have any regrets. Life can only be better than this with you, my sweetheart. I love you. I'm a blessed, happy birthday, sweetheart.
One. 2, 3.
Happy birthday, Daddy.
We love you.
Turn up.